pessoal, senhor.
I'm thinking what may be the last case of PBR extra that I'll be able to find, which is great. Just regular PBR, but it has 6.5% alcohol instead of 5.7%. Trogues Brothers that makes an 11% honey and cherry Belgian ale, and fucking I drink it all year round, even though it's supposed to be a Christmas only beer. They only make it once a year between like October and Christmas time. No, I don't get it all the time. I just buy a shitload of it when it is available and stock the fuck out of it because. There's even bars that sell it, like, aged for a couple years after it. Like, we went to a place last year that still had 2015 and 16 cans. So. But it's one of the few beers that actually age really well. Yeah, I definitely agree with that. But this one is stupid expensive.
Wow, K-Dog is still flagging all over the place. Oh shit.
Yes, there are. I like the 90 better, but just because I don't like it so hoppy, I had to get the 120 gets pretty hoppy. What's the other thought fish you like, babe? Stumbling into walls and shit. Yeah, yo, I like that. Yes. Definitely. There's a couple different Dragon's Milks that they make. Different flavors and other random shit they add to it.
Distribute founders at our job. Yeah.
That is one of the things about Pennsylvania is there's a hell of a lot of good crap. The Wiggle Whiskey brand, the guy who owns the Pirates actually bought that too, and a lot of Pittsburghers are pissed off about that because, like, they liked Wiggle Whiskey and they want to like the Pirates, but this motherfucker never spends enough on their team that their team sucks every fucking year. So a lot of people are mad that he bought what was a good whiskey company and might now not be a good whiskey company. As soon as it happened, I said, "Oh great, they're gonna make the whiskey out of Pirates fans' tears now."